Good morning, everybody. Welcome behind the scenes here at Jamie Riddler Studios. I am Jamie, and it is Monday, the beginning of another week, the perfect time to cast forward and figure out what are we going to get done this week? What are we going to create this week? What are we going to accomplish this week? What are we going to give ourselves a gold star for this week? And oh, so many things to choose from. I have to share that I am coming off of a weekend where I am feeling so immediately and intensely the power of art. You know, we often talk about the power of art in our creating it, in our expressing ourselves through it, but I'm also thinking about the power art has to connect us, the power it has to move us as receivers, the power it can have in inspiring and creating meaning in our life and helping us think through things and making us feel like as human beings we are in it together. This weekend, I had the great blessing of being able to sing in a tribute to David Bowie at the Art Gallery of Ontario with my choir. And we sang Space Oddity. And what amazed me, and I'm going to share a clip with you at the end, and there is an official video, so I'll share a link to that too, so you can see and feel what the experience was like. What was truly amazing was here were these words to a song that I feel like I've known forever. In the context of David Bowie passing, these words suddenly had new meaning. And in that context, also singing them, hearing them after having lost my mom, they had new meaning. And being married, they had new meaning. And there were layers and colors of my own life experience and the world's life experience that now created an additional dimension for me in these words. And this is one of the powers of art. It's one of the reasons I love theater too, that there are words, the words of Hamlet, can be filled and layered and come alive in new ways over and over and over again. Or a song when it's sung by a different person. Or a poem when it's read at a different time in your life. Or a piece of artwork that stops you in your tracks. When was a time that art touched you in that way, when it changed you, when it transformed a situation, when it woke you up to something new about the world or about yourself, or where it put into expression something that felt inexpressible in your own life and in your own heart? And as if that weren't enough, this weekend I was reading the Brain Pickings newsletter, and one of the books that was featured is called When Breath Becomes Air by Paul Kalanithi. I hope I'm pronouncing that in a semi-semblance of right. A neurosurgeon who wrote through his own experience with cancer and his own experience coming up to death. So I guess art was a theme for me this weekend, and death was a theme for me this weekend too. And I was reading his expression and how he talked about looking for meaning and really caring about meaning. And for him, one of the places he found meaning was through literature. And he quoted Beckett and the power of these very, very simple words: "I can't go on. I'll go on. Those still make me teary. I can't go on. I'll go on." 7 words, simple, short words, that in a they could be a child's book. And it took me right back to when my mom was sick with cancer. And so many times we would say to one another, "This is too much. This is too much." And yet we showed up again and again and again. And so when I hear those words, "I can't go on, I'll go on," they say something to me about my life experience. And they let me know too that this is a human experience. that this is something we unfortunately all sometime in our life will likely have an opportunity to say. And having those two sentences together is somehow also so empowering and triumphant. I can't go on. I'll go on. Yeah. So, all of this to say that in our world of words and color and shapes and songs and stories and movement, we have an opportunity to experience life, to connect with meaning, to recognize that even in these moments where we are faced with something that feels like we are so alone, in the way that we humans understand and share and are a part of this life together, we are also never alone. It's one of the reasons I like to show up here for the BTS. It's one of the reasons I started doing the podcast and helping people share their stories about their own creative life, is so that we could experience that, so we could say, I'm not the only one who's going through this. And others have gone through this and they have gone on. And maybe that will encourage me to go on too. So I am so glad you're here, whatever you are experiencing. If you are feeling the need to be encouraged to go on, I hope this inspired you. If you are feeling like you want to be immersed in inspiration and connection and art, I hope that inspired you to make that a part of your week this week and every week. And I hope that you'll share some of your stories about how art changed something for you, how it opened a door, how it transformed your heart, how it made you feel less alone. I'd love to hear. Thanks so much, as always, for being here behind the scenes. I'm so glad we share this time together, this journey and its ups and downs, its lights, its shadows. All of it is a part of our creative life, and we are in it together. I will see you tomorrow.
Can you hear me, Major Tom? Can you hear me, Major Tom? Can you hear me, Major Tom?